Welcome everyone. Today in computer aided design session we will study basic concepts of FEM, specially focused on one dimensional elements. There are also another cases called as a three dimensional elements, but those cases can be considered during the solving the problems in ANSYS or SolidWorks or Creo. Myself Prof.Kunalsinh Kathia from Saffron Institute of Technology and serving my duty as a professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. So let's begin. First, let us understand what is the FEA process. So now, finite elemental analysis approach works on two basic things. The first one is the displacement and second one is stresses. Now let's take an example of this one, that I am having one book. Okay, and according to this book, I'm trying to push that book at the bottom side, top to bottom, and trying to pull it also. Now here this FT is acting as a friction force. So how the FEA solves it? FEA first tries to figure it out that how much displacement will be there. So this will be the major criteria for me, displacement. And according to that displacement, I'll figure it out that how much stresses are getting produced. So on that base, I will come to know that what will be the conclusion for it. Now, next one, if we say that any FEA problem, to determine this displacement and the stress, you required these things. What? First is boundary condition. Boundary condition mean what? Means that, let's say that I am having one box. Let me draw that box here. And imagine that this box is in 3D. So what we require? That we require the boundary of this box. We must know and we must have to tell that this will be the boundary for this box. So why? Because in this boundary, FEA problem will get solved. Because we need to tell to FEA process or to the FEA solver that this is my boundary, this is my limit, and that's why it is known as a finite elemental analysis. So first thing will be the boundary, and the second one is forces acting on the body. So here you can see already an example. I told you that book is resting on the table. So we need to tell to the FEA that how much force is getting applied at the downward and what will be the frictional coefficient for it. So according to it, given my boundary conditions and forces, it will try to figure it out that what will be the stresses generated at various points, body or object. Okay. Now let's see what's next, how it works. Similarly, like me, you might be scratching your head that yeah, we came to know that displacement and stresses can be determined by this process, but how basically it works in background, how FEA solves this much bigger problems in very smaller way, very shorter way. See, I have also listed the question that how FEA can determine the stresses at the end of the bar. You can see that in this bar, this is a FEA analyzed problem. In this bar, you can see that at the end, it shows a major deformation, displacement. And you can see the stresses generated in the colored manner. So how it works? So in this session, we are here to clear it out also that what will be the basic background process to solve this. So now let's move on further. What's next? To determine these stresses and displacement, FEA uses one standard procedure. We need to just understand that how FEA brings out a problem to the solution. In previous slide, we have seen that forces we are giving and it determines the displacement and reaches to the solution. That is the stress generated. So now let's see that what are the steps that FEA follows to solve your problem. Step 1, first it tries to find it out forces. So when we are giving that how much forces are acting on that element, FEA process immediately starts dividing that element into the number of the parts. That is called as the meshing. Second, stiffness matrix. Now FEA applies the force equation on that each and every elements and solves the stiffness. Third, displacement. Now FEA tries to figure out that how much displacement is occurred due to this force. Fourth, strain displacement matrix. According to this displacement, we'll come to know how much strain is produced in this bar or cube or any element. Next, strain. Ultimately, after strain displacement matrix, FEA has the data that on each and every element how much strain is getting produced. Next, according to the strain, it will figure it out the stress strain matrix. And because of stress strain matrix, we will come to know the relation between the stress and strain. And at the last, we will come to know that what is the final stress produced in the whole element. Just summarizing out, first forces, then we are getting a stiffness matrix, then we are reaching to the displacement. After displacement, we are getting that how much strain is produced in the element. Then according to the strain matrix, we will come to know that how much strain is produced per element. Then after the strain, we will come to know that stress and strain matrix. And because of this matrix relation, we will come to know that what is the stress produced. So this is how the FEA follows this step to solve your problems. Okay, now let's move on to the next slide. Forces. Now we will understand the basic steps of FEA. We have seen the flow, that how FEA solves our problem. Here we will try to understand in simple language that how this process goes in background. First the forces. So here is the cantilever bar beam and it is attached to it wall, and the F force is acting on downward. So let's say that 10 kN is acting on it. So now this is the input parameter for me. So FEA will take it as an input parameter. And now it will try to figure it out that how much kilonewton will get distributed along this bar. So for that, what it needs to do? It needs to divide this bar in multiple elements. So it will try to fracture it out. It will try to subtract this bar in number of elements. It will look like a mesh, and that's why in FEA we are telling it as a meshing operation. So each and every element will have its own equation, its own value in kilonewton. So it will be very easy for the FEA process to find out that what will be the resultant force acting at this point or any at this point. So these are how the FEA process divides the forces in number of elements. Next is stiffness. Stiffness is simply, you can say that it is the to move easily and without pain. Stiffness means that internal resistance of that material. So it tries to figure out that how much stiffness is there, and stiffness is indirectly a material's property. So FEA problem requires a property of the material also, because without material property we cannot come to know that how much resistance it will give to the offered force. Okay, so now let's move on to the next slide. After the stiffness, we will come to know that displacement. It is the action of moving something from its place to the position. What is happening? That in displacement, when you are applying a force on any bar or any element, what it does? It moves that element from one point to the another point, or it gets elongated. So FEA tries to figure out that how much it got elongated. So let's say that if one element is here and I am applying a force, so it will get ruptured in some way, will look like this, under pressure. So FEA will try to figure it out that how much rupture happened in that one, right? So displacement of the node, it figures out there are many number of nodes connected together and each node has a proportional displacement to the another one. In the previous that when we have seen that we are dividing that bar into number of the elements. So now after applying the force, each and every element will have some displacement. So if I am applying a pressure on this resting book on the table, then this book will deform like this. And FEA will figure out that how much deformation occurs here. After the displacement, we will find it out that how much strain is there. And strain means what? Change in length upon original length. So as you are applying a pull force on this bar, it will change its length. And in previous step we have seen that we are finding out that how much displacement of this bar happened from initial to the end stage. So this difference will be called as a delta L, and according to delta L and original length we will find out the strain. Strain is a description of deformation in terms of relative displacement of particles in the body that excludes rigid body motions. Okay, next, finally, the stress. In continuum of the mechanics, stress is the internal resistance. It's internal forces that neighboring the particles of a continuous material exerts on each other. There are many definitions for the stress, but simply, if we take it as a formula, then it is a load applied per area. So after knowing the deformation of that bar, we will come to know that what is the stress, because we know the stress and strain relationship. Okay. Now let's see in next slide the whole process together. And because of this chart, you will understand that how FEA solves its problem in very simple manner. First, we have seen that forces. Then it figures out the stiffness matrix per element. After the stiffness matrix, it will come to know that how much displacement. So each and every element, how much displacement happened or occurred will be stored here. After the displacement, we will come to know that what will be the strain matrix. According to strain matrix, there is a relation of stress and strain. So we will get the final result as a stresses. See here, I will try to explain you by this cantilever beam. Let's say have this kind of cantilever beam having a rectangular cross section. So first, we are defining the force at downward. After that, FEA will divide this whole bar into the number of elements. Okay, that operation is called as a meshing. Okay, and because of meshing, now FEA has a number of parts of this bar, and these parts are known as a elements. So this all parts, all elements has a separate value of force associated with it. After this applying this force, it is finding out the material property, which kind of material it is, whether it is a MS or either aluminium or copper or anything, any kind of material, it has a different properties. And after this property multiplication with the force, will give the displacement of every element. This element displacement will give the result of strain, and this strain will give the result of a ultimate stresses. So this is how the total FEA process works in this number of steps. Step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If we understand this process in basic, then easily we are able to understand the FEM methods or FEA methods that we'll discuss in detail in the next sessions also. Now summary, the step 1 force, strain, displacement, elongation, strain and the stress. Okay, so finally how much stress is getting generated we'll come to know. So thank you everyone for attending this session. In next session we'll come with something new. Till that, Goodbye.